much life do you think a banyan tree can support?
Actually, nobody knows. Because animals come and animals go. So if you're talking about all the animals on the tree, then there's going to be a lot of life. More animals go to a big tree than typical random trees.
So here I am in the middle of the banyan tree. In the middle, I discovered a man-made shrine, or what was a man-made shrine. There's only little parts of the shrine left, about two or three of the walls that's still around. The shrine, I guess, is a really more than a 50 years old structure that was once part of the banyan tree, but then the banyan tree just took control and grew over this structure, and now it's almost barely visible from the outside. So when I was coming in through the roots to come to the center of the tree, I saw a lot of insects and a lot of life. There were spiders, cockroaches, lizards, flies, beetles, and a few brown mouse here and there. And it was just, there was a lot of things going on, and it was very surprising to find out that there were so many things happening in the roots. There's a kind of a hidden ecosystem that's not visible from the outside. So what I plan to do is to tie a few of my camera traps onto the roots of the tree and place them facing into the roots of the tree to take any pictures of anything that moves inside this banyan tree, and to see what kind of images can be created from documenting these movements and this ecosystem inside the tree. I've initially wanted to camp on a hammock inside the roots, but since I discovered this man-made shrine and there's still some roof attached to the shrine, I think I'll be spending the next 3 or 4 days here to observe the tree and to see what happens inside the middle of the banyan tree. And the reason why I'm staying here is because this is the center of a man-made structure that this banyan tree, this natural force, have overgrown and swallowed and enveloped this whole structure. So I think it'll be interesting to base my observations here in the heart of the man-made shrine inside the tree. I think it's not useful to look at photographs, whether it's real or not real, whether it's fact or fiction. To me, photograph is always something that wants to be real, but it can never be.